The Prusa XL comes with 0.6mm nozzles, which is larger than the standard nozzle size of 0.4mm.
Larger 0.6mm nozzles are ideal for printing large, single-color objects. However, for multicolor prints, switching to a smaller 0.4mm nozzle offers several advantages.
Regardless of nozzle size, walls are usually printed with two perimeters.
Since 0.6mm nozzles have larger extrusion widths, the two perimeters are thicker and use more filament. While thicker walls may not be a major concern for single-color prints, it has a noticeable effect on filament usage for multicolor objects.
In multicolor prints, the slicer creates separate perimeters for each color, resulting in unnecessary walls on the inside of the object. With a 0.4mm nozzle, these walls are thinner and less wasteful.
In this example, switching to a 0.4mm nozzle on a single-color model saves 15 grams of plastic.
But when the object is multicolor, a 0.4mm nozzle will use around 55 grams less material than a 0.6mm nozzle for the same object.
That's almost a 20% reduction in filament usage. The exact amount saved varies from model to model, with the most noticeable differences observed in prints with multiple perimeters and colors. By using a 0.4mm nozzle, you can effectively conserve plastic and minimize the amount of excess material used in your prints.
0.4mm nozzles generally produce less stringing than 0.6mm nozzles.
For single-color prints, stringing isn't a major concern, as any strings can be easily trimmed or removed with a heat gun.
However, in multicolor prints, stringing is absolutely a problem to avoid. Strings from one color can become embedded in the walls of another color, leaving behind unsightly marks that can't really be removed.
Stringing can be minimized by printing at lower temperatures, using dry filament, and by using a smaller nozzle size.
These temperature towers were printed with temperatures ranging from 180 to 220 degrees Celsius. The tower on the left was printed with a 0.4mm nozzle, and the tower on the right was printed with a 0.6mm nozzle.
In both cases, less stringing is observed at lower temperatures, with 190 degrees Celsius giving the best results. However, stringing cannot be completely eliminated with the 0.6mm nozzle. By using a 0.4mm nozzle, stringing problems are significantly reduced, which will translate to much higher quality multicolor prints. There are two factors that limit print speed: the maximum movement speed of the printhead and the maximum volumetric flow rate. That's the most amount of plastic that the hot end can melt and extrude over a given amount of time. That's something that is affected by the type of filament, the hot end's thermoconductivity, and the print temperature.
For PLA, printing at 190 degrees Celsius minimizes stringing. So we need to figure out what the volumetric flow rate for PLA is at that temperature.
We can find out by printing this test object designed by CNC Kitchen. I've sliced it so that the flow rate starts at 8 mm³ per second and then slowly increases. This allows us to observe when the hot end begins to struggle, which will result in under-extrusion and gaps in the layers.
With the 0.4mm nozzle, print defects start to appear when the flow rate exceeds 15 mm³ per second. These defects appear even earlier with the 0.6mm nozzle, meaning this nozzle can't print at flow rates higher than 11 mm³ per second.
So, it turns out that the 0.4mm nozzle has a higher maximum flow rate at lower temperatures. That's crucial information when choosing a nozzle size for multicolor printing.
In Prusa Slicer, you can enter the maximum flow rate under Filament Settings, Advanced. The default value of 15 mm³ per second is too high for the 0.6mm nozzle at low temperatures, so we need to adjust this.
Here we've sliced a simple cube for both nozzle sizes After implementing the correct maximum volumetric flow rates for PLA at 190 degrees Celsius. With the 0.4 mm nozzle, the print is expected to complete 45 minutes earlier than the 0.6 mm nozzle.
That's a really significant difference in print time. Looking at the print speeds, it's pretty clear that the 0.4 mm nozzle can take advantage of speeds unlocked by input shaping. But the 0.6 mm nozzle can't. Not if you plan to print at low temperatures. Whether or not this translates into savings in print time will depend on how much of the print is spent at these faster speeds.
If you plan to do a lot of multicolor printing on the multi-tool Prusa XL, one of the first things we recommend is to swap out the 0.6 mm nozzles for 0.4 mm nozzles.
This will help you reduce filament waste, improve print quality, and also decrease print times.
We hope that you found this information helpful. See you next time on 3D Print Dogs.